and many do not have a full understanding of the prayer. The prayer is performed simply. Whenever one faces a decision, he or she would first need to do their part by researching possible solutions to their quandary. They should put their intellect and rationale to work, assessing the circumstances to their best of ability. One then would seek sound counsel from others that are knowledgeable, wise, trustworthy, and genuine, and who are worthy of consultation on the very issue. One should use his or her God-given intellect to weigh all available options, reflecting and pondering all gathered research and advice to determine the best possible outcome. Once one determines how to move forward on the issue, he would then pray 2 units, rak'at, a voluntary prayer, which should not be counted as a part of the 5 obligatory prayers of the day. It is important to note, one should not pray istikhara until he has chosen the course of action he plans to take regarding the matter. The prayer he performs would be similar to any other traditional prayer. One must make wudu, ablution, in a clean, pure state, dressed appropriately and facing the qibla, in the direction of the Kaaba, God's house here on earth, in modern-day Saudi Arabia. It is also recommended to seek God's forgiveness and mercy at the beginning of the prayer, especially if you consistently commit sins. After completing 2 units of prayer, one would then recite the supplication taught to us by our final prophet, Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. If one has not memorized the dua, the supplication prayer, he can then read it from a piece of paper. It is to be recited in the Arabic language, just as our Prophet taught us. Yet if one is new to Islam or cannot read Arabic, then one can read the transliteration. During the supplication, a moment arrives where the one praying would name the question or decision he faces in any language of his liking. While it's best to state the matter verbally, one can also think or visualize their need in their minds. When one is praying or supplicating the istikhara, he is asking God the Almighty as to whether or not they should move forward with a particular matter. If the divine answer is yes, that the person should move forward with a certain option because it would benefit him in his religion, this world and in the next world, then one is asking God in his supplication to carve an easy path that would allow him to facilitate this decision. If the divine answer is not to go with the seeker's proposed solution to the matter, then the one praying is asking God to create a barrier between him and the matter at hand, to remove him from the situation. Additionally, the one praying is asking God to remove the love of his choice from his heart, thus preventing him from pursuing that option. Many harbor the misconception that the answer they seek will come in a dream or a vision, or that the answer will appear magically to them. While that is possible, the divine response will not necessarily arrive in the form of a dream. Furthermore, one does not need to make the prayer at bedtime. The prayer can be given at any time of the day, besides the 3 basic times of the day when people are encouraged not to pray. The istikhara prayer is not meant to change or play with one's emotions necessarily. Yet in answering the prayer, God might place an inclination in one's heart that will guide him to go through with the action he chose for them, enabling them to feel a sense of peace and contentment with their decision. On the contrary, the one that gets a negative response may feel doubtful, apprehensive, and averse to moving forward with their matter. The main way that God answers a prayer is by clearing the right path while closing all other avenues. If the divine answer was no, then one might oversleep that day, suffering a flat tire on their vehicle, experience the rejection of a marriage proposal, or encounter another circumstance that blocks the path they initially chose. One should look out for signs that lead them in the right direction. It's imperative for the one seeking an answer to